The bottom line to all this, Roxy, is I'm not going to accept any married students for the fellowship. It's a big catch-22.
And this fellowship's supposed to last a couple of months?
Yeah. I just don't know what to do.
Well, I do. We're just going to have to wait to get married.
Roxanne, wait, no wait. Now, I've waited a lot longer than I wanted to marry you.
I bet you waited even longer than that to become a doctor. Like all your life?
Yes. You were my first priority in all of this.
And you're mine, too. That's why I want you to go for this fellowship, Rick. It's real important.
Roxy, listen, I just don't want to mess things up now that we finally got things worked out.
You're not. Listen, I am so proud of you for wanting to become a doctor. And seeing you work for something and dig in like... It made me fall in love with you in the first place. Don't you laugh. It really made me look up to you.
I'm not laughing. All right? I love it when you see my praises like that.
I am serious. I want you to go after this fellowship thing. And least I can do is give up a marriage for a couple of months. It'll make me feel like I've helped. Like I have contributed something to you becoming a doctor.
Roxy, I don't know.
Oh, come on, Rick. You can just think of it as sort of like a present to me.
Man, this is getting scary to me. You know, I'm actually starting to understand your logic.
I always knew you were a smart one.
All right. As soon as this fellowship is done and over with, no more delays. We're getting married right away.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. And this way the wedding invitations can read Roxanne Shane and Dr. Frederick Bauer.
I love you.
We showed a loyal medicine.
There you are.
Yeah, I was about to get my feelings hurt. I thought you two had left the party.
Not a chance. Mindy, this is your night.
Oh.
We've been out on the porch making plans for our future.
Well, buddy, looks like it's in the air, huh?
Have any plans to go down the aisle soon after us?
Well, Mindy, depends on your idea of what soon is.
Tell him about the fellowship.
Well, I decided to go through the accelerated med program, and if I get through it without having a nervous breakdown, I'll be a doctor in a few months.
A few months?
Right.
That is great.
So when's the wedding?
Just as soon as Rick gets that MD hooked on the back of his neck.
If I do.
You will.
Yes, you will, because you always get what you want, Rick.
Mindy, I love it when you talk positive like that. Can I borrow your fiancé for
I'll tell you what I'll do, I'll trade you.
Oh. Thank you.
Wait.
We've talked like this before, haven't we?
I think we have.
The four Musketeers are back at the end here.
Can you guys tell me how we've managed to let so much time slip by without getting together?
I know, after everything we've been through together.
That's right.
You know, I think we should make a pact tonight.
Dave!
That we won't let our friendship slip away anymore.
Now that's a deal.
We just needed something to remind us how much fun we had together.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mindy.
Do you get the funny feeling that we've all grown up?
Yeah. But do you think maybe just for tonight we can pretend we haven't? Tell me.
Did you put that on the jukebox?
Well, as long as we're going down memory lane, I figure...
Philip, that prom was the night that my whole life began.
I wonder if I'll ever feel that way again.
I'll give you all the joy my heart and soul can give.
You're leading, Mrs. Vandermeer.
Oh, well, that's only because you're following Mr. Vandermeer.
Mindy.
You were really in love with me at once, weren't you?
Yes, I was. I think we learned together.
You were the one to show me how I could rely on myself when I had to.
Mm-hmm. And you taught me, Minnie, that it was okay to rely on somebody else sometimes.
And I taught you how to vacation in the Big Apple without credit cards, right?
Oh!
Oh, God, I wish you could have! Just watch where you're going!
Wait, quick! Here.
Oh. There she is.